Hey everyone, Marine here for Lone Fun. Thanks for joining me on this new video. As always, let's see which stamp and die sets I used to create this card. First, the Shadow Box card die set. From that set, I used the main panel die, as well as the hill dies and the window die. Next, the stamp sets. I like you a little. Ocean Shelfie for the jellyfishes, camera, fish and rocks. Then Sweet Den for the open book. You Are Sublime for seaweeds, lobster, fish and hearts. Christmas Fishes for rocks and seaweed. Fantastic Friends for some fishes. Bicycle Built for You for the hat and veil. Mermaid for You for the star and shells. Keep on Swimming for the puffy fish. Happy Village for the first part of my sentiment. And Swan Soiree for the second part of my sentiment. So this card is going to be a very colorful underwater scene that features two cute axolotls getting married. And I gathered a whole bunch of fishes and underwater critters to create cute guests. I stamped the images using jet black ink and used the coordinating dies to cut them all. And I used my spectrum noir markers and graphite brush markers to color everything. Thank you. Once the coloring was done, I moved on to the background elements, and to ground my little underwater scene, I cut two hills that I colored to be sand, and I used anti-clinen oxide ink first all over the border, and next I added a little bit of red burlap oxide ink at the top just to bring more contrast. Next, I moved on to the box, so I cut two shadow box panels out of Strathmore Bristol cardstock. I kept one panel and used blue shades to create my underwater background. I first covered the paper with peacock feathers oxide ink. Next, I used blueprint sketch oxide ink to darken my panel. I applied the ink on one half and used peacock feathers again to blend the colors. To create a bubble effect, I splattered water droplets on the paper that I dried using a paper towel. And next, I mixed some blueprint sketch oxide ink with water and used the same brush to add tiny dot details on the paper. And to save some time, I did the same thing off screen on the other side and colored the other shadow box panel the same way. Before starting to assemble the box, I created a window opening on one of the panels. I taped the rectangle die from the shadow box die set and sent everything to my die cut machine. Next, I folded the panels on the score lines and I used my bone folder to get a crisp fold. And I also folded the tabs on the sand borders and applied strong double-sided tape on the tabs. And I attached both borders at the back of the window panel, right on the small rectangle section at the left of the window. Next, I applied tape on the tabs on both panels. I flipped them over. I put both panels next to each other and attached them together. Next, I peeled the backing paper off the sand border tabs. I made sure that both pieces were straight. I folded the small rectangle panel on the left to stick it to the tabs, removed the remaining backing paper, and folded the window panel to finally close and form the shadow box. Next, it was time to assemble the images and stick them inside the box, but I realized that it would be complicated to do that with the box closed, so I reopened it and taped it to my glass surface. And then I finally attached some of the images inside the box using glue dots. Next, I wanted to add more images to my scene, so I created a flap. I just cut another shadow box panel and I didn't need the tab, so I cut it off. I also used the same inks to color that panel and white heat embossed my sentiments. I folded that panel on the score line and this is how it will look like. My shadow box will have like a door that I can open to see the inside. But before attaching that flap on the box, I needed to decorate the front and the back. Off screen, I created more sand borders that I attached on the paper. And next, I stuck more images using liquid glue. So here I have my additional panel and my shadow box with all the images. I used a white gel pen to add highlights on all of them, and next I finally attach the flap or door on the box. And now we have a door with a cute fish that says congrats. And when you open the door, the sentiment reads wishing you a lifetime of happiness. And we can see a cute axolotl couple getting married. We have a cute lobster leading the ceremony, a jellyfish taking pictures, and also some cute happy guests. And that's it. I hope you like this lovely underwater wading colorful scene. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye!